welcome to Ask Your Aromatherapist, and we are still doing some myth busting. And today we're going to talk about babies and toddlers. So there are a couple common myths about essential oils and toddlers. So you're a parent and you are trying to figure out what's best for your kid. And a lot of us have been there. So you think reaching for the natural option is the best choice, but and with essential oils, they're natural, they're wonderful. But is natural always the best or safest thing? Most often, it's all about dosage and how you use it and why. So with babies and toddlers, we don't actually get their informed consent. They don't have the ability to communicate with us if something is super, super wrong or they don't want something. We have to decide what's best for them. And we definitely all understand that. So with babies, we like to be very cautious. And I mean, along with the natural is safe or natural is the best, I always go with the line of thinking like, would you eat a bar of soap from Rocky Mountain Soap or like from the apothecary? No, you wouldn't, because you'd be burping bubbles for a while. You wouldn't eat a tablespoon of borax. So natural doesn't necessarily mean safe, and it's all about how you do it, and how you use it, and how much you're using of it. So with babies and kids, you want to use probably about half or less than half than you would use on yourself. And you would want to go very slowly because you would want to make sure that no allergic reactions are happening or developing. So just, you know, for safety's sake, go slow. Monitor reactions and check them out, see what they're feeling. And when in doubt, lavender, almost always the best. Tea tree can be a little bit irritating, but it's still safe. So just like I said, do a little bit of a test, a patch test, we call them, and see what happens. Go slow, less is more, and listen to your babies. And I bet you're doing a great job out there, parents. Love you. Bye.